Okay, we're on Psachim. Perek Zayin, Mishnah Yud Aleph, 11th Mishnah in the 7th chapter of Psachim. So there's a rule. Okay, in there, there's many rules. In the halachot of the eating of the Korban Pesach, we learn a bunch of things. The first thing we learn, the Torah says, is, let me see if I can make this a little bit bigger. There we go. V'lo totiru mimenu ad boker. You can't leave the Korban Pesach until morning. I mean, that's an isur d'oraita of notar, of leaving it. But v'hanotar mimenu ad boker be'esh tisareh, tisrofu. But if you leave it until the morning, then you have to burn it with fire. Okay, you can't leave it over. Whatever's left over has to be burnt. Similarly, there's another isur. We learn later on, this is Perek Yud Gimel. Skipping down, Shemot Perek Yud Gimel. Okay. Vayomer Hashem Moshe v'Aharon, El Moshe v'Aharon, Zot Chukat HaPasach. These are Chukat HaPasach. We've learned this before. Non-Jews can't eat it, etc., etc. Okay. Toshav Yisachir Le'ochol Bo. Bebayit Echad Yeyachel. It has to be eaten in one house. Lo totzi min habayit min habasar chutza. You can't take from the basar. Once it's in the house, you can't take it out of the house. Ve'etzem lo tishbru bo. Nor can you break any bone in this animal. You have to eat it without breaking any bones. Now, this sounds very simple, but these halachot are rather complicated. Because when I say v'lo totiru mimenu ad boker, there's an isur d'oraita of notar. What that means is I have to have enough meat to serve everyone, but not so much meat that I have left over. So I have to plan on eating everything. Someone's got to eat the tongue. Someone's got to eat the guts. Someone has to eat everything. So I have to have, I have to have enough people, enough meat for everyone to eat. Similarly, remember we learned that this animal is a very young animal. It's a gedi. It's a goat or a sheep less than a year old. The bones are extremely brittle. They're extremely small. So therefore, while it sounds easy, etzel lo tishberu bo, don't break any bones, that's easy for certain things. But not for all the bones. That's the topic of our Mishnah. Mishnah says the following: Kol ane'echal b'shor hagadol ye'echel b'gedi harach. Anything that's eaten, so any part of the animal that's eaten for a shor hagadol, for a big ox, that could be eaten b'gedi harach for the very very young, very soft gedi, very soft little goatling. Bartanura adds, okay. See, because in the big animal shvaru shekol ha'ati likashod bo, all the big bones. All the soft bones have hardened for a big animal. He says, but so those big bones must be eaten. They have to be eaten, but you can't break the bones. It's very interesting. And the bones, when they're young, are sort of cartilage that can't be broken. So it's a bit more complicated than you think. So they must have known, they must have known in their times what could be eaten and what couldn't be eaten. The Bartanura adds, that which is not eaten, so in the big animal, once it gets hard, it's not edible. So you can't include that for the little animal either. Even though now there are certain, sinews, I don't really know, certain parts, certain cartilage that's going to become bone. People could eat it. But now, since later on, if it became a hardened bone in the older animal, it wouldn't be edible. You can't count that as the edible part. Now, the Mishnah continues. V'rashei k'nafayim v'hasach suchim. Rashei k'nafayim are the wings, but there are no wings on animals. Sachsuchim. So let's look at the Sefaria English translation for a second. Okay. Tender kid, right? Including the tops of the shoulders and the cartilage. Sachsuchim are cartilage. Let's go back to our Mishnah. What in the world is this talking about? It says about Tanura. Hachika Amar. This is what it means. Umau ne'echal b'shor ha'gadol. What's considered edible in shor ha'gadol? Rashei k'nafayim, the wing heads, which means haschus, the cartilage that's called tanrus. Shibarosh kafa katev. It's cartilage at the top part of the shoulder. Okay? Ushar sachsuchim, other cartilage. Kagon tnucha ozen, like the earlobe. Usichuse hachazeh. Chazeh is the chest, the cartilage. Vatzlaot akton, the small ribs. Shibasof hashidra, at the bottom of the spine. Ho ilu b'shuragal de'echalim ayadei shlika. Since in the shuragadol they're edible. Yechlu begil gilia b'gdiharach atzali. They are edible. They should be included in that which is edible in the young kid. I do want to point out, that's how the Bartanura learns this Mishnah. The Rambam learns it in a different way. He learns the whole thing to refer to etzem lo tishberubo, because we're going to learn etzem tishberubo, don't break bones, in the second half. So he says, this is true, etzem lo tishberubo, kol ne'echal b'shor ha'gadol, anything that's edible in the shor ha'gadol, yechel b'gdiharach, can be eaten, v'rashei k'nafayim v'asach suchim, including these things, okay? One second. Because if you break an etzem rach, you have to be careful. If you break a very weak piece of cartilage is going to be a bone, that's a problem of etzem lotish berubo. That's a problem, says that you shouldn't eat it, even though, one second, it's, you can eat it. Yes, that's right. I'll just read it. He says, Hayagdi katan varach, if it's a very small kid and very, very soft, you shouldn't eat these bones because shezesh over etzem. So the Rambam learns these halachot regarding the breaking of bones, not regarding the question of what's considered part of the meat to be included. The Mishnah continues. Hashaveret to etzem bepesach tahor. If you break a bone in a korban pesach, that's tahor. Harezeh lokeh arba'im. You get malkot. That's an isur d'oraita. Okay, that's an isur d'oraita of, that we learned in the pasuk, etzem lotish berubo. Here we go, etzem lotish berubo. But amotir betahor, if you leave over for a behemah torah, the animal when it's tahor. V'hashover betameh, and if you break a bone when the animal is tameh, eino lokeh et arba'im. So they learn out, etzem lotish beru bo. See this word bo? It is included, but if the animal is tameh. What about hamotir betahor? Motir is to leave over. And we learned, where are we? Lototir mimenu ad boker. So how come lototir, you're not chayim malko? So the Kahati gives two reasons. Let's see if I can find in the Bartuner. Yeah. Why? It says, lototir mimenu ad boker. Okay? But then it says, as we saw, v'hanotar mimenu ad boker be'esh tisrofu. Whatever is left over, you have to burn in the fire. Ba'katuv litein asei achar lo ta'asei. You could put an asei after lo ta'asei. That, I mean, I made you a little primer here. Let's go to the bottom. That's called lav, it's hanitak la'asei. A lav, an Easter lav, a negative commandment that's connected to an asei. This is a classic example. It says, don't leave over, lo totiru, but if you do, v'hanotar, then there's an asay of burning it in fire. That's asay achar lo ta'asay. And any lav ta'asay, lomar, im avarta alav, kayem abo asay shabo, ve'encha loke, alav shenitak la'asay, ein lokin alav. Second reason is, it's a lav she'en bo ma'ase. The only time we give malkot is if you do an action. Don't do this and you do it. Don't break a bone and you broke the bone. But here, what's the act? What is the action? Lo totiru, it's a lav she'en bo ma'ase. So therefore, ain't lokin alav, because what did you do? You didn't do anything. You just left it. You didn't take any action. And in that case, the halacha is, ain't lokin alav. We're going to finish. Okay, shover betameh, ain't loket arba'im. Why? Because it says, etzon lotish bru bo, as I've said. Bakasher musar, your only issur of breaking the bone is on an animal that's kasher, not an animal that's tameh or pasul. We'll stop here and dedicate our learning to the memory of my father, of Simcha ben Yitzchak Kalman. And you can email me if you have comments or questions. Have a great day.